Only 25.9 million individuals of all the forcibly displaced are officially classified as refugees. 83% of them have been in continued exile for more than 5 years. Unable to return to their home country, they remain in a temporary situation awaiting decisions on their applications, stateless, or in perpetual internal displacement. We are De Justicia and Legal Agenda, two human rights organizations from the Global South working on refugee policy in both Colombia and Lebanon. We are demanding a radical reform of the international refugee regime. The current regime has failed. Every year, barely 0.3% of those classified as refugees are provided permanent resettlement. This system allows states in the global north to refuse to share equitably in the responsibility to protect refugees. It aggravates inequalities between countries of the global south and the global north, and it worsens the already unbearable conditions of the forcibly displaced. Worse still, the global pandemic COVID-19 exacerbated the shortcomings of the existing system. The countries that account for two-thirds of the total global GDP only host 10% of the global refugee population, while major refugee host countries that are already facing huge structural barriers to sustainable development host 72% of the global refugee population. At the same time, Colombia, Peru, and Ecuador host about 74% of the forcibly displaced population in Latin America. Refugees are forced to remain in host communities that already suffer from dysfunctional and oppressive governments, many of them accused of corruption and persistent human rights violations. Geography is the key determinant of first countries of asylum today. Crossing borders to neighboring countries is often the closest shelter. Of all host countries in the world, Lebanon's refugee population is the highest in relation to its national population. In 2018, Venezuelans accounted for the second largest flow of new international displacements, 36% of whom took refuge in Colombia. In response to this flow of migration, states in the north have closed their borders to refugees and communities in the global south. The treaties that form the international refugee regime have failed to establish binding enforcement mechanisms. Without them, states are not being held accountable for refusing to share in the responsibility to protect people seeking refuge. European and North American states have actively pursued policies that prevent the displaced from reaching their borders. Since 2016, any person seeking refuge at the Greek border without official permission is detained with the aim of being sent back to Turkey. And since the Trump administration's zero-tolerance policy, every person crossing the border into the US without a visa can be criminally prosecuted, whether or not they are seeking refuge or asylum. The current regime ensures that the vast majority of refugees remain in a permanent limbo. Without the right to work and in the absence of legal status, many people who are forcibly displaced do not have access to medical care or education, ultimately seeing their future prospects narrow with time. Xenophobic practices attacking refugees are on the rise in many host countries. In Colombia, Venezuelans are often cast as criminals, despite the lack of evidence to support this claim.
Pero por favor, no más en Girardota generando desorden.
Syrian refugees in Lebanon are often subjected to labor and sexual exploitation, curfews, and arbitrary arrests and violence. Refugees also face the risk of being illegally sent back to their country of origin. In 2019, Lebanon started deporting Syrians who enter the country illegally, without allowing them to defend themselves against deportation orders. The same year, the Danish government also adopted a new law directly violating the principle of non-refoulement. Repatriation programs to return refugees previously resettled in Denmark.
بعد سنتين من لجوئي انا وعائلتي اخترنا اول عائله بكل الاتحاد الاوروبي قررت الحكومه الدنماركيه اعادتنا لسوريا.
The US is diverting asylum seekers to apply for refuge in safe third countries which are not very safe, like Guatemala. Asylum seekers are finding themselves in the same conditions as the ones they were trying to escape.
We are now at a point where we just get along, and they're doing what we've asked them to do.
Agreements to provide foreign aid in exchange for keeping refugees in host countries have not solved the problem. In countries such as Lebanon, where corruption in public institutions is a major issue, sending aid to government institutions does not substantially contribute to supporting refugees and hosting communities in need.
All the world's nations made a striking commitment.
When the UN's General Assembly adopted the Global Compact The international community failed once again to develop binding obligations on all states to provide permanent solutions that would enable refugees to build sustainable futures. Caught between the devil and the deep blue sea, the forcibly displaced are stuck. On one hand, in host countries with crumbling resources, deprived of their legal rights to residency, work, and social services. On the other hand, they are refused any opportunity to legally resettle in countries with the infrastructure to provide them stability. Global problems require global solutions. A fundamental change to the refugee regime is urgently needed in order to remove forcibly displaced communities from permanent uncertainty and to structurally support host communities in the global south. We, together as the international community, need a regime that distributes the global responsibility towards refugees in a fair, equitable, and sustainable manner. We need a mechanism obliging all countries to receive and resettle refugees proportionally to their means. It is a global responsibility to reduce inequalities among refugees and host communities in the global south.